Mr. President, we have a national emergency.
This is one of the things that we can shoot first and ask questions later. Normally you can't do that.
All of a sudden these trees started moving out of the way. They parted for me. And then I came out into this opening, and there where I saw Jesus Christ.
Party ticket said the American people would never vote for socialism. But he said under the name of liberalism, the American people will adopt every fragment of the socialist program. Is more imminent.
James Madison, 1788, speaking to the Virginia Convention, said, "Since the general civilization of mankind, I believe there are more instances of the abridgment of the freedom of the people by gradual and silent encroachment of those in power than by violent and sudden usurpations."
End Time Prophecy News with your host, W. Dean Shook, is on the air.
Into this Memorial Day program. Thank you, everyone who's listening through our regular broadcast networks, our Blog Talk Radio Network, the Spreaker Radio Network, through our regular broadcast affiliates across this country. For those of you in the UK and Australia, thank you so much for joining us here today. I'm going to play a little clip that I just did for this show alone. If I still have listeners, after I play this clip, we're going to start our discussion about First of all, what we're our war right here in America, the war that we're battling every single day. Then we're going to talk about the brutality, the utter brutality of war over the last century. I'm going to play this clip. Stand by.
American men and women, military and civilian, have given the ultimate sacrifice, their lives, to preserve the freedom and liberty for all generations to come. No, America is allowing an Orwellian power grab by a tyrannical government to nullify every last life that was sacrificed for our rights and freedoms. Our fathers, grandfathers, and great-grandfathers who gave their lives for our freedoms will be for nothing if we as Americans don't do what our greatest generations did, and that's to fight for our freedoms. So tell me, America, is a life sacrificed for freedom of so little value that we, the recipients of their sacrifice, can't get off of our dead asses and honor them by doing the same thing they did to fight for our freedoms? Remember, freedom is not free. If you want it, you have to earn it and defend it. If you don't, you lose it. Is this a new day in America or a final farewell? You decide.
From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say
down the tube, and all of those possibly will be lost for nothing. For nothing. Tell me this. Are we the great political Babylon that's described in chapter 18 of Revelation? Let me share with you what this says, and you tell me if this does not sound like the pit of pornography and violence that America has become today. First one, and after these things, saw the angel come down from heaven, having power, the earth lightened with his glory. And he cried mighty with a strong voice, saying, Babylon, fallen, is fallen, has become the habitation of devils, and the hold of every foul spirit, and a cage for every unclean and hateful bird. God's judgment. Through this angel who's crying, Babylon the Great is fallen. Why? She's become the habitation of devils and the hold of every evil spirit imaginable. She's a cage of continuing, vicious, filthy, hateful bird in existence. And all you have to do is walk through some of the major cities today: New York, Detroit, Chicago, L.A., Hollywood, San Francisco, all of America's major cities. They're loaded with lust-ridden sinners. They're seeking sex thrills through prostitutes and X-rated movies, pornographic stores. Could America fit this description of this political Babylon as a cage containing every unclean and hateful bird, controlled by foul spirits and demons who inhabit the land and its people? God help us. Verse 3, all nations have drank. Now listen to this. All nations have drank wine of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. What other country in the world has the kind of delicacies that America has today? Who does the large trading in the world? It's America. What have we allowed ourselves to become? Verse 4, and I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people. Ye be not partakers of her sin, you receive not her plagues. That you receive not of her plagues. For her sins have reached unto heaven, God hath remembered her iniquities. Verse 6, reward her seven that she rewarded you, and double unto her double according to her works. In the cup which she has filled, fill her double. Verse 7, how much she hath glorified herself, lived deliciously, so much torment and sorrow give her. For she saith in her heart, I am a queen and no widow, and see no sorrow. Is that what America's attitude is today? That we sit as a queen. We sit at the top of the heap. Nobody can take us down. We will see no sorrow. Is this us? What we're about to see is God's law of sowing and reaping. They that plow iniquity sow wickedness. Humanity can't get away with sin forever. This is going to be a terrible experience as this Babylon, if this is us, receives double portion of judgment. Literally, the verse should say the double is to be doubled. This was the punishment of under the law of Moses in Exodus 22. Now God says, double the judgment upon Babylon according to her works. Reward her even as she has rewarded you. Babylon has glorified herself and lived deliciously. Her wealthy has become wealthier. Her poor has become poorer. As a nation, she did not care about the folk, the poor, for she said, I am a queen. I shall see no sorrow. Now, there's a possibility that James chapter 5, 1 through 6 predicts this judgment that's going to be administered in Revelation 18. It says, go to now, ye rich men, reap and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. Your riches are corrupted. Your garments are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver is cankered. And the rust from them shall be a witness against you, and shall eat your flesh as if you were fire. You have heaped treasures together for the last days. But behold, the hire of the laborers who came reaped down your field, which is for you kept back by fraud. What does that mean? The people that came and worked for you, where you're supposed to pay them a good, decent wage, you fraud them out of that money and pay them little. In America, corporations, especially large corporations, they want to hire illegals because they can pay them next to nothing and work them 12, 14, 16-hour days, 7 days a week. It is by fraud. They're cheating these people. They're using them, just like they did in the slave days. When the Democrats came out in the slave days and said that our economy in this new America cannot last without this free labor. Well, of course, we prospered without